Hello everyone, today I would like to tell you about the lightest material on planet Earth, aerogel. As a matter of fact, there exist quite a lot of kinds of aerogel. Some of them consist of metal oxides, for instance aluminium oxides. Others can consist of carbon tubes and graphenes. By the way, such an aerographene is a few times lighter than air. However, I cannot manage to get this rare material. That is why today I am going to show you classic silicon dioxide based silica aerogel. As you can see, this material is very fragile and it crumbled when it was transported in the package. When aerogel crumbles are put on paper sheet, that it looks translucent and very light, and it is almost invisible against a light background. Aerogel's density is extremely small, about 1/10 of a gram per cubic centimeter. The density of aerogels of higher quality can even be compared to that of air. It's not surprising because aerogel mostly consists of air. To illustrate that aerogel structure is like, we can compare it to that of any other gel-like substance. For instance, water bell or shampoo. Now try to imagine that all water in such a material has been substituted with air. Roughly speaking, this is what aerogel looks like from inside. Small porous material filled with air or another gas. It's quite easy to make aerogel. First, regular silica gel has to be made, for instance by mixing together tetraethyl orthosilicate and ammonia solutions in methanol medium. Later, such a gel is washed with methanol in order to wash away all traces of water. After that, it is sent to a supercritical extractor. Let the complex names not scare you, because everything works as simple as a bicycle. Carbon dioxide is pumped under pressure into such an extractor. After that, the case of the extractor starts to heat up. The liquid carbon dioxide passes to the supercritical state, that is, becomes something between liquid and gas. In such a state, it can easily wash away methanol from gel, substituting it with gas. This is how aerogel forms. The first thing you can notice when working with this material is the sound it makes when falling on a solid ground. Since aerogel has a solid silica framework, it makes a loud noise when it hits another surface. Besides, aerogel is also one of the best heat-resistant materials, heat conductivity of which can be lower than that of air. I decided to conduct a classical experiment with it. I put a small flower on a piece of aerogel and started heating up the aerogel with a powerful blue torch. The flower withers on the edges, but it practically doesn't change in the middle. If we take a smaller flower and more powerful gas burner, the effect will even be better observed. I am heating up the aerogel with a very powerful spot burner, with a temperature exceeding 1000 Celsius degrees. But nothing is happening to the flower, because it is protected by the most heat-resistant material. Such a low heat conductivity is also the result of extremely small pores of this material that rarely exceed 30 nanometers in diameter. It's even smaller than the mean free pass of a gas molecule before colliding with another such molecule. By the way, I also noticed that upon heating up with high temperatures, the surface of aerogel starts melting, because silicon dioxide this material consists of begin to melt at such high temperatures. However, not everything is so rosy. There are certain cons too. First of all, aerogel is very fragile. Look at how easily it crumbles when slightly pressed. Later, it turns into fine powder that is hard to remove. The main problem with aerogel, especially with silica aerogel, however, is the fact that it is hydrophilic, because this material has hydroxyl groups on its surface. When it comes into contact with water, aerogel soaks all the liquid and turns into a whitish surface, similar to colloidal silica. Thus, if water is spilled on aerogel, it will immediately lose its unique properties and will turn into quite expensive rubbish. Anyway, progress does not stand still. And people have managed to make water-resistant aerogel with the help of some hydrophobic material. It substitutes hydroxyl groups on the surface with hydrophobic ones. The production and use of this material is steadily growing. Some companies have invented flexible aerogel, having mixed silica gel pieces with fibrous tissue. This material is widely used for insulating rooms and also for making modern warm and light clothes. Besides, aerogel pieces can perfectly absorb extremely small particles. Because of that, they are used as comet dust catchers on Stardust spacecraft. Also, because of the large surface area, carbon aerogel can be used to make supercapacitors, and silica aerogel can be covered with particles of other materials and used as an effective catalyst in chemical industry. It also noteworthy that aerogel is used for thermal protection in some cars, for instance in the transmission of Chevrolet Corvette C7. As a result, we can say that today aerogels are modern and useful materials, new uses of which we are yet to discover. For the provided aerogel, I'll thank the company onyxmed.com. I'll put a link to their site in the video description. If you would like to support the continuous production of science videos like this one, please support channel on Patreon, link in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting videos.